Next morning they had cause to congratulate themselves upon the useful condition of the Gump, for with daylight a great flock of jackdaws approached to engage in one more battle for the possession of the nest. But our adventurers did not wait for the assault. They tumbled into the cushioned seats of the sofas as quickly as possible, and Tip gave the word to the Gump to start. At once it rose into the air, the great wings flapping strongly and with regular motions, and in a few moments they were so far from the nest that the chattering jackdaws took possession without any attempt of pursuit. The thing flew due north, going in the same direction from whence it had come. At least that was the Scarecrow's opinion, and the others agreed that the Scarecrow was the best judge of direction. After passing over several cities and villages, the Gump carried them high above a broad plain where houses became more and more scattered, until they disappeared altogether. Next came the wide sandy desert separating the rest of the world from the Land of Oz, and before noon they saw the dome-shaped houses that proved they were once more within the borders of their native land. "But the houses and fences are blue," said the Tin Woodman, "and that indicates we are in the land of the Munchkins, and therefore a long distance from Glinda the Good." "What shall we do?" asked the boy, turning to their guide. "I don't know," replied the Scarecrow, frankly. "If we were at the Emerald City, we could then move directly southward, and so reach our destination. But we dare not go to the Emerald City, and the Gump is probably carrying us further in the wrong direction with every flop of its wings.